The first time I saw Ian Gottrick was in Iceland on a very snowy day in the very far north, and here comes this guy crawling out of his car in his Adidas tracksuit. I just spent the night in like sub-zero temperature, and I was just like, wow, this is one of the most hardcore stoked to surf human beings I've ever met in my entire life. And he went out and just proceeded to just get so many fun waves, so many barrels, and just was living it, you know, had the alien mask and just an epic sense of humor, and just one of those people that you really feel grateful to come across in those kind of elements when it's just the weather's at full velocity and he's just smiling like like he's the happiest he's ever been. So yeah, Batty's just one of those crazy dudes that you just, I don't know, I've never met anyone like him.
out in the silence. Can you feel my heart is trembling? You looking for truth, looking for an answer, looking for an angel. I'm searching for justice, searching for Jesus, looking for. Looking for an angel.
I know Ian Patrick for maybe 5 or 6 years now, and I have already so many stories to tell on this guy. But the last one, I was with him. We are on a surf trip in the Arctic, in the middle of the winter, and we want to check a new spot. So he go in my car and we start to drive. But the weather start to be crazy. It's snowing so much and the wind is so strong, just impossible to see outside. It's a total whiteout. Suddenly the car just stop. We are stuck in the middle of nowhere. So we understand we need to call the rescue team because it's impossible to get out of the snow with our tiny cars. It's minus 15. It's the strongest wind I have ever seen of my life. We have no idea of where we are. We drove many hours in the whiteout. He has no phone, I have no connection, and we have no maps because usually we know the coastline in our mind. So we just tell the rescue team, we are in this part of the country. Just drive all the road and you will finish to find us. They arrive maybe 5 or 6 hours later. Because the storm is too big, so we have to let my car here for many days. So they drop off us at the car of Jan, 1 or 2 hours away. And we will spend the next 2 days here. 8 surfboards in the car, no place where to sit, 0 food, and impossible to go outside to take a piss. It's too windy. Just trapped here in his tiny car, talking shit for 2 days, enjoying the weather. And it's where you realize why Jan is so relaxed with a situation like this, because he's coming here every winter for months, for more than 20 years, alone. No phone, no maps, just trying to surf anyway, by any weather. Surfing in the Arctic is so complicated. People see perfect video online with nice backdrop. They think they will arrive here, just score directly, have the shot of their life with the mountains. But you arrive there and you will have to face stories like this before scoring. That's for sure. But there are some windows between the massive storm with wind and the no wind, so no waves. But those windows, they are very short and mostly you can't predict them. It's unpredictable, even with the best forecast ever.
The weatherman came on the radio, said there'll be sunshine. And all the colors of the rainbow fell.
I can't really remember the occasion, but I met Ian Patrick several times on his trips here during winter times, probably about 10, 12 years ago. Maybe more. I'm not sure, but I remember him. Like, he was quite quiet guy. Didn't say much, but he surfed really well, and he got a knowledge for that. He also got a knowledge for some really strange things. Like, the whole time I've known Ian, he has never stayed in a house in Iceland. Never. In February, in minus 20 or whatever, storms and all that, he was usually just renting some old Subaru Legacies or just something, and just with his sleeping bag and a, like a small travel stove in there. He probably did like 2 or 3 sessions during the day, and it's not really warm when you come out of the Arctic Ocean here in Iceland during the winter time, and that alone, to stay in his car as well and wake up in these freezing mornings and had to really like warm up and energize before you get in the water. I admire the guy. Like, he just bit something in himself, like, I'm not gonna stay in a house. And I remember one time I offered him to stay at my place. Like, there was this really bad storm coming, and I'm like, hey Ian, you should maybe just stay in my place. And he was like, no, I'm not gonna break that vow. Like, I'm not gonna, like, break the streak, or I don't know what you call it. Just being stubborn and like, this is what I do, and he stuck by it. And for that, you know, to do this, like, it gives you like a huge amount of freedom to be able to go anywhere and not be relying on staying in someone's house or whatever. You can just stay wherever you want, really. I've also, like, I've traveled a bit with Ian around the country, and we've scored some places that have never been surfed before. I think I'm quite secure to say. And I remember this one time we drove this like off-road through some farming fields, and we found this really awesome wave, and we surfed it. We had to paddle a bit far out and walk fair share to get to there, but it took a while. When we came back, we noticed that the soil had defreezed. So when we drove through there, everything was like frozen. So when we were going back, it was all just mud. And we got stuck there for a couple of days because we couldn't get through, like, and we were in the middle of nowhere, so there was no way for us to call a friend or, hey, can you pick us up or whatever. So we just looked at the weather forecast and we saw that there was about to be a mild freeze like a couple of days later, and we waited until then, and after some hiccups getting stuck a few times, we eventually got out of there. Yeah, but like all those crazy adventures with Ian, like, camping in the middle of nowhere, meeting some people sometimes not, like, and just purely soul surfing. Like, you're not doing it for the camera or recognition or anything. It's never been the agenda of Ian. That's like, it's pretty respectful, like, to not be the guy that is has to be on social media or like, he's hard to reach when he's here. Like, you try to call him and it's like almost impossible because he never has the SIM card and he only, like, he's only reachable through the internet. And okay, it's gotten easier the last few years, but like 10 years ago you couldn't reach that guy because he was like, you texted him something and he replied like a week or two later. So no hookups there.
During the winter also, we have limited sunshine because we're so far up north. Let's say in January, the sunlight is maybe 4 hours a day. And you have to fit then all of this in with the tide. And you have to get really, really lucky to sneak in a surf session here. And with the snow, you need like a big Jeep to access many of the surf spots. So I wouldn't recommend it to anyone, even though you've seen pictures which are kind of perfect. That's not maybe the case in reality. So Ian Patrick has spent like 20 years here living in a car and like really put in the time for a strike mission. This is maybe not the place.
Nah, it was like the first time I met Ian, man, it was like, fuck, I'd known him for years, hey. Of all his like adventures in Iceland, like years. I've been here for 20 years now and like he was here for so much longer. And it's just insane what this guy's been doing. Not to mention, one day I watched him, it's -7 degrees outside, oh, yeah. Snow. He paddles in the corner here, takes his wetsuit off in the water to take a shit.
Oh no, I think you're gonna edit that thing out.
Yeah. Isn't it dead? It's good to know a living legend, man.
Yeah. He's very unpredictable. It's like,
yeah.
It's trying, asking Ian a question. It's like, when are you leaving? It's like, I don't know. When you go, what are you doing? He doesn't know. He's just in the moment. Yeah, he just does what he feels.
Yeah, he's in the moment.
It's magic.
There's no planning. There's no planning.
And he's got a company. It's just amazing. How does he do it? It's what he lives for, man. Just being free, next to the ocean and just surfing.